Do you have peace? You might wonder whether anyone could be at peace in this troubled world. There's trouble everywhere. Trouble on the news, trouble in our homes, trouble in our hearts and minds. Jesus said in the Gospel of John, chapter 14, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." You see, without peace, all we have is trouble and fear. Jesus offers peace, but not the kind of peace the world gives. He said, "My peace I give unto you." What kind of peace is that? Well, perhaps you've heard about the time Jesus and his disciples were in a boat on the Sea of Galilee. A great storm came up, and the boat began to fill with water and was about to sink. Where was Jesus? Asleep in the back of the boat. He certainly wasn't afraid. He wasn't troubled. He was at rest. Well, the disciples woke him up screaming that they were about to die. And what did Jesus do? He rebuked the wind and the waves and said, "Peace, be still." And there was a great calm. Now, the disciples were at peace after Jesus rebuked the storm. But Jesus was at peace in the middle of the storm. You see, that's the kind of peace that Jesus offers. Why was Jesus at rest? Well, because he's God. He is the creator of heaven and earth. He's in control. He knows the future. God never panics. Jesus offers this kind of peace, his peace. How? Well, Jesus explains that at the beginning of John chapter 14. He says this, "Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also." Jesus offers you a home with him in heaven. Nothing in this short life can trouble us when we know that Jesus is our Savior and we know that heaven is our home. That's why Jesus is the source of peace. He is peace. How can you be sure that heaven is your home? John 14, verse 6 says this, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." You see, Jesus claimed to be the only way to heaven, and he is. He's the Son of God, God's only Son. He came to this world. He died on the cross for our sins. He was buried. He rose again, and he offers eternal life, a home in heaven, to all those who trust in him. If you will receive him, if you'll trust in him, call upon him and ask him to cleanse you of your sin, he will give you the gift of eternal life. He's preparing homes right now for every single person who has called on his name and received him as their Lord and Savior. Will you do that today? Will you trust in him? Ask him to save you. He'll hear your prayer. He'll give you eternal life, and you will receive the gift of peace. God bless you.